We didn't come at this as if it was a normal movie.
To approach it in this direction was a gigantic task.
There wasn't anybody that had done this before.
We knew that it was going to be relatively experimental ground.
Singing live in a film has never been done with this kind of consistency before. That changes every bit of the process of doing it. There's been a tradition of experimenting with live singing within the filmed musical, but because of the way technology and creativity has moved on, there was an opportunity here to do something genuinely groundbreaking.
There's been some huge advances with radio mics. We've gone for something which gives us as close to a studio sound as possible. And basically, we're radio miking every actor. Sometimes on Les Mis, we're running up to 26 tracks of radio mics.
And just so you know, we've got two radio mics and two booms all on. So somewhere within there, you've got a lovely piece of work.
We all know movie sets are very, very noisy places.
Today you might also have known how your world may be changed in just one burst of light.
We've come into this with an ethos of this set will be quiet.
If you're off camera and the camera's over here shooting a close-up, please don't be here sort of shifting around on that, okay? You could just be standing still because you know you're not on camera.
If we want live vocals, we cannot have extraneous noise. The sets have to be specially deadened down.
We're constantly trying to sneak bits of carpet in to get rid of footsteps. Rather than having wind machines on the set, we've created a silent wind tunnel where the actual machinery that creates the wind is outside the stage. The sound department is three times bigger than you would have on a normal big Hollywood movie.
We were all extremely pleased at how good the job Simon had done. It was quite an amazing achievement.
It's the best sound recording I've ever heard. I mean, categorically, I've never heard anything like it.
When you first see the songs and the way that they're performed, especially on the close-ups, you know that there's just absolutely no way you could ever re-record those in a studio and get all those breaths and every single noise of the mouth.
One word from him and I'd be back beneath the lash upon the rack. Instead, he offers me my freedom. I feel my shame inside me like a knife.
Actually, preserving that stuff was what allowed you to know that it was real.
Tom always said he didn't want an overly produced soundtrack. He wanted it to feel like the person was doing it right there and then in front of you.
Oh, my friends, forgive me. That I live and you are gone.
The thing about the live vocals is if I tried to introduce a little bit of reverb onto the voice or something to place it into the location, generally it didn't work very well. It was better to always be as real and as honest as possible.
In the darkness, the trees are full of starlight, and all I see is him and me forever and forever.
The fact that they're singing live, you're so keen to protect the performance. So, for example, a horse and cart. In any other movie, you would add the sound of a horse and cart. But it didn't always work to do what we'd normally do.
Suddenly, you're here. Suddenly, it starts.
In this, the horse hooves were oddly intrusive unless they were in a very sympathetic rhythm to the music.
One day more, another day, another destiny.
And then finding musicality within sound effects became a thing. When the bishop lifts up some candlesticks from the table and the candlesticks are tuned to continue the musical note.
Would you leave the best behind?
You get a sequence like Dream a Dream is this very, very fragile recording.
Then I was young and unafraid.
1 or 2 dB of orchestra music too much and you overpowered it. It really had to feel that it was just sort of cradling her voice because the performance on the day, it was fantastic.
No song and song, no wine untasted.
It was an extraordinary experience. And everybody felt that it was breaking a lot of very new ground. You got to find the language. And the language in this film comes right from the actors' hearts.
Life has killed.